but those battle flights off the Nimitz will soon pause for a day. In response to the McCain and Fitzgerald accidents, Richardson, who is Chief of Naval Operations, removed the commander of the Navy's 7th Fleet and ordered all ships to pause while they ensure safe operations. Among the questions they are supposed to answer, are sailors standing watch with vigilance? Are they communicating with commanders when problems arise? Are commanders responsive or asleep at the wheel? And the Nimitz is in a unique situation, conducting combat operations in two countries. A large ship like an aircraft carrier can't simply be shut down for a day, so the pause will have to be planned and coordinated carefully. We have to find a way to do the pause, Kurtz said. It's important to do it. Byrne said the entire air wing will try to do it all in one day. He said the wars make it difficult for the wing to just shut down operations, so the pause will have to be planned for a day when airstrikes aren't needed from the carrier. Visiting the Nimitz and another Navy ship this week, General Joseph Votel, the top U.S. commander for the Middle East, offered condolences for the lost shipmates. He called the incidents a heavy reminder of what comes with service to our nation. On the USS Vela Gulf, Votel met one young man whose friend was among the missing in the McCain collision. It was very difficult for him, said Votel, who returned to the U.S. this weekend after an 11-day trip through the Middle East and Afghanistan. American troops, he added, must be absorbing lessons learned, paying attention to what's out there. The thing that we try to emphasize with our folks is that you've got to be careful of complacency, Votel said. Complacency kills out there.